I invested in a program called Acid Pro. That's kind of what I first started making music with. I started collecting records and sampling stuff and making stuff inside that program. A lot of the stuff that I did was just all sample-based, finding old records, weird things like little drum records or exotic type-looking records where they have weird drum beats and stuff. I would sample all of that. And the stuff that I was making, it was kind of influenced by hip-hop, but I also really liked drum and bass, so I was trying to mix the two of those things together. My big influences at the time are Amon Tobin. I think that, like, when I first heard his stuff, when it first came out, I was blown away by it. I love the idea of him taking something old, sampling it, remixing it, chopping it up, making it into something new. I mean, I went to art school and started combining art and printmaking and digital imaging and learning Photoshop and those types of things. So that's kind of like, at the same time learning all of that stuff, I started learning how to make music on computers. I think computers are just my tool. You know, some painters use paintbrushes, I use a computer. I have this one knob set up for like this crazy, crazy short delay. It makes it sound robotic. When I was first getting started with the MWG sound, I had mentioned earlier that I wanted to keep it a secret, like it was this new artist that I had signed to Exponential, my record label. Some of the remixes that I were doing were starting to catch some buzz, and early on, Herb caught wind of the remixes and they included me in their top 100 artists, like next 100 artists, and they wanted a photo. So we were trying to figure out, what to do. I want to send them a picture of me because then everybody know it's going to be me. We're just going to put this Lucha mask on and then take the picture and send it to them, and it'll be kind of funny, you know? I stuck with it and started using the mask when I played live shows, which is really cool, man. I at first it was kind of awkward wearing a mask because you feel self-conscious, but then at some point you realize no one really knows. It's a mystery what kind of facial expressions you have going on behind there, and it's really liberating, man. I mean, putting the mask on is almost like stepping and becoming in a different character and stuff like that. The beginning phase of Mexicans with Guns, like I told you, I was remixing stuff. And I was just doing bootleg remixes. If I heard a song that I liked, I would remix it just for fun. One of the first remixes I got asked to do was for Friends of Friends Volume 1, which was Daedalus and a group called Jogger. I just finished my 8th year of teaching. I've taught high school, middle school, I've taught alternative school. I got into teaching just because I liked computers and I felt like I could share that knowledge with some of the kids that I teach. If you work with vocalists, throw the vocals in, acapellas. Because this track sounds cool, but I only have a tiny little loop of it that's just playing, so that could get old real quick. But if I throw in an acapella on top, with electronic music, I feel like there's a million ways to do things. So, I mean, there's never one right answer for something. So it's always good to hear how someone else does something, because, I mean, you hopefully pick up something that you can kind of use in your bag of tools. I have my daughter in here. I sampled her. It's really weird sounding. Horrible recording. I think you can hear the TV in the background. There's something going on in the background, but... So, I mean, if I have a whole track playing, I can still throw in stuff like that. I'm looping that little beat now. Instead of playing that whole Obsidian track, I'm just looping that first drum intro, too. In Mexico, they have a holiday that celebrates any loved one that you've lost. You build an altar for them. And some people, they create these sugar skulls, and they paint them, decorate them really cool looking. So this is based off of that. The earlier remixes, they're more like fun party tracks, and I felt like the Lucha Mask kind of represented that. And since a lot of my music's been becoming more tribal and serious sounding and darker, I almost feel like this mask better represents that sound. I mean, I've always been into weird stuff in general, but I started wanting to learn more about a shaman in Mexico named Maria Sabina. And I was just really interested. Basically, what she did was she would combine like weird half Catholic rituals with mushroom eating ceremonies, where she would basically heal the people in her tribe by giving them just all these mushrooms that grow naturally in her region. So, I mean, to me, I feel like there's definitely some kind of link between psychedelic drugs and what it does to your brain and religion. It was just interesting to learn about that because, I mean, in a way, it's kind of like a lost part of who I am, being Mexican-American. I don't know anything about the Indians, the indigenous Indian people that were in Mexico, you know? That's kind of where I come from. But yeah, so it was just interesting for me to learn about this. And it's stuff that I'm already naturally into, so it was really cool for me to find out all this stuff. And so I felt like learning about that kind of, it made me want to start making more tribal sounding music, something that sounded kind of psychedelic sounding and weird, but had a tribal effect with drums and percussions and a lot of the shakers and different instruments. For the album, my friend brought in a bunch of different little percussion instruments, just weird things that made noise. A lot of them were just bones too, like goat hooves tied together on strings that you could just shake and stuff like that to create all the percussion. So, I mean, that kind of is what, with all that stuff in my mind, that's what shaped this album. And here's, came out from all of that stuff. I decided to call it Ceremony because I felt like it kind of went into, it could be cool music for a ceremony, but I feel like a lot of ways electronic music is music for ceremonies. I feel like when you go to a rave and there's music playing, it's really repetitive. People start dancing. It's almost trance-like. So it's just this overall really weird spiritual type of thing. And I feel like electronic music somehow taps into that more so than other forms of music. What keeps me motivated is just, it's the one thing I love the most, you know, besides my family, obviously, but making music, I mean, you do it because that's your passion, you know? I don't think that'll ever fade for me. It's just something I love and have to do. It's my form of expression, you know? So, I mean, I'll definitely keep doing it till I'm old. I'm on the highway to hell, man. Yeah. Highway to hell.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Welcome to DubSpot. We believe in providing you hands-on experience right away. Whether you're completely new to music and want to turn the sounds in your head into a musical reality, or you're an experienced artist looking to refine your skills and add new tools to your arsenal, we're ready to meet you at your level. For students of all ages, all levels, and all styles of music, DubSpot is here to help you achieve your goals. With course offerings both online wherever you are and at our school in the heart of New York City, we are ready to guide you through the next phase of your musical transformation. Whether you want to produce music, DJ, or do both, you've come to the right place. Come explore DubSpot for yourself. Become a part of our community and make music.